so very, very glad that you decided to be on time today. Very shocking. Today's lesson is going to be quite different from the last. As you may recall, last lesson I taught you about potion making, or rather, ingredients used in our potions. Do you remember some of them? Yes, I have newt. Yes. Thimbleweed. Good. Very good. I'm glad to see that you're remembering our lessons, and that I'm not doing this in vain. Anyhow, today our lesson is going to revolve around talking to other magical folk through various different means. I will show you two of them today, but there are many different ways to do this. Keep in mind that everything that I show you in these lessons is not everything that there is to magic. We will go further in depth, and I will show you many different kinds of means of talking to people. The various different methods, of course. But for now, for today's lesson, we will focus on two. The most commonly used. Alright. Good. The first, and probably one of the most favorable, because they can be used in are the ever loyal tarot cards. Yes, yes, they can be used for fortune telling. However, you can also use tarot cards to talk to both the living magical folk, such as you and I, or our dearly departed. Although that's an entirely different lesson. Yeah. sorceresses, and so on and so forth. Doing so is quite easy as well. First, we split the deck in half. It does not matter which half you use. And we begin to shuffle. All the while, keep in mind who you are trying to contact. Try not to look at the cards while you're doing this now. You are trying to let your higher being. Think of someone who you are talking to, or wish to talk to, you know. It could be anybody, it could be your sister, your brother, your grandfather, the butcher, the baker, the candlestick maker, I don't care. You just think of someone who you want. Your eyes and let the deck just fall into place. Just let the cards just fall. We will lay out our spread. As you can see, we have placed the cards evenly onto our table. And we are going to work on our spread. It's very important that you place the cards on top of the deck that you had previous. Excellent. Now we are going to work on our spread. First, tap on the cards 3 times. Next, lift the pile and think of the person or persons that you want to reach, who you are trying to contact. So, the cards were correct. I am trying to contact my father. He is one of the most powerful wizards. Not in the entire world, but definitely one. Three of Wands pertains to his kingdom. That is to say, it has something to do with him, of course. The Three of Wands talks about someone who is trying to contact those who it pertains to. So it would be me in this case. Eight of Cups. Cups mean something that is trying to acquire a thirst for knowledge, so to speak. So this is a very large thirst. I am trying to acquire something very specific, something very dear to my father. And he's a Swords, one of the most notable of cards. That is to say, I wish to ask him if one day I will be as powerful as he is. The cards are showing me what I would like to tell my father. Here is when I can choose to omit some things. I can choose ask him something else. But I think I'll go with this spread. The cards seem to have read my mind perfectly and completely, and I think they did a very good job, so. Excellent. Next, we concentrate on the cards. We think of our recipient. We think of the question. We think of ourselves. And we think. And tapping on the cards releases all of your energy into them. It's very helpful to do that. You can either tap like so, or you can wave your energy into the cards like this. See, as I'm waving my question towards my father, now, what we do is we tap on each and every card 3 times each. take a look at what my father responded with, shall we? The first card, the High Priestess. Second card, the Star. Seen some of the ways that you can contact other magical beings. Away the cards now. Next, we're going to try something else. Another method of contact. This time, we're going to use one of the most preferred we are going to use the crystal ball to summon someone of our choosing. Not my father, though. Anyway, when we have objects like this to others, we must make sure that we have their permission to contact them at any time. You really do want to make sure that the person that you're contacting is close to you. Doesn't necessarily have to be family, no. A close friend works just as well. The reason for this is being that you wouldn't want to catch them at a bad time. There have been many a time when one is taking a bath and the crystal ball just happens to glow and you just can't really do anything much about that, okay? You just don't want to see something like that. Anyway, make sure that the time of day is appropriate. If you can, set a date or a time and specify with each other when it is okay for you to summon them or for you to summon each other. Okay. It's very important to always have consent in these things, of course. Now, please take a look. This is my crystal ball. Yes, it is quite lovely. Thank you very much. And I'm going to show you how to use it. Hopefully one day you'll be able to crystal ball. Some witches believe that crystal balls are the future of apprentice training. You know, teaching from the comfort of your own home. I say, whatever happens. Face-to-face teaching. All of this new age crystal ball teaching is just so overly done, you know. But alas, I must teach you how to use it. You never know when it could come in handy. In order to use the crystal ball, you must first become one with it. You must place your energy into the crystal, much like you put your energy into the cards, if you remember. We hold the crystal. We put our energy into it. We stroke the crystal, tap the crystal, pat the crystal, in order to transfer our thoughts, our ideas, our emotions into it. That way you can get a very clear reading. And your summoning will be perfect. You need lots of concentration to keep the signal going. Do you understand? Good. So, in order to build a connection with your crystal ball, you must treat it with respect, with love, give it attention. Caress it as if it were your child. And transfer your energy. Remember, hold the crystal. Now we concentrate on who we are trying to call upon. Who is it that we're trying to conjure? Think. Call their name out in your head. Sorry, if I caught you at a bad time.
Oh, it's you. Your timing is impeccable as always, bitch.
Good. I'd like you to meet my apprentice.
It's a pleasure to meet you, and please accept my condolences on landing the White Witch as your teacher.
He is one of the
and I'm not even an alchemist. I'm just a man who's has access to the arcane and the magic stream.
Yes, my friend. I was teaching them different ways to contact magical beings. Through varying methods, we've covered tarots, and now we are just...
There are many ways.
We are covering the art of contact through crystal ball. I hope you don't mind. Well, a part of me couldn't help it. I thought of you because of our recent conversation.
Reading tea leaves, for example. However, all of these need a something on hand if you're walking up the hill picking flowers, for example, and you just don't happen to have a giant crystal ball on your person. What do? If you need to make communication with another wielder of the magic, that is where astral projection spirit walking, as some call it. Very interesting.
That's good. Yes, that's a good one.
A cup of tea is a good one. Walking the plains of space and stars is magical.
I hear that's quite difficult. How do you get on with it?
Well, it's not too dissimilar to lucid dreaming. One must access the arcane energy on the core and rise out of their body.
You must have me over for tea sometime and we can talk more about that. Oh yes, I'm quite interested. Yes.
I'll consider it. You see, astral projection is difficult.
What are you going to be doing later on today?
Well, as I've just discovered, I'm out of red mane. There's a patch that grows on the top of Tilikon. It's a beautiful little hill and offers a splendid view. We can go together and I can explain the structure behind spirit walking and some of its pitfalls.
I think I may join you, if you don't mind.
Most welcome, despite the intrusion.
Well, it's just that sounds very, very interesting.
As well it does, because it is. You see, the thing with astral projection is that it allows speeds of travel.
Well, thank you for being a part of my lesson. And for helping me explain to my apprentice some other ways of conjuring or summoning or talking to some other magical folk.
You mean accessing the arcane to access communication lines?
By means of magic, of course, yes. You're right.
I always am. You knew this?
To let you go now. Yes.
Well,
I'm going to hang up on you.
How rude of you, after intruding like that. That is so like you.
Good.
It's fine.
Okay. It was nice to see you.
I wish I could say the same.
And I'll talk to you later, all right? We'll make plans for later on.
You better be a diligent student.
Good. Good. I'll be seeing you very, very soon then.
I look forward to it.
Good.
always a pleasure, White Witch.
Goodbye, then.
Goodbye.
And those are just some of the ways that you can contact other magical beings, other magical folks. Yes. Oh yes, he is extremely, extremely powerful, very wise, also wisecracking. Yes, he's very funny. Perhaps one day I will let you two meet. Well, that is all for today's lesson. I'm so very glad that you were able to join me today, and that you enjoyed this lesson. Remember, it's all about connecting to your method, connecting to your various magical objects. Once you form that bond, you will get a stronger, clearer, better reading, better summoning of whoever you are trying to contact. Keep that in mind, and you will get it in no time. So very, very glad that you enjoyed this one. Yes. As always, you can remain here to study or to work on your Book of Shadows. Leave whenever you feel like it. You're very welcome to stay. I, however, will be doing some readings on my tarots while you do whatever it is that you want to do. Good. Yes, you may leave whenever you feel.